This is a true story of five skaters
going across America.
Coming from the east side, going to the west side, flowing to the north and the south. You know what we're about, so send let 'em check it out.
You know it's funky, so funky like Monkey Manua. Even more funky than a dirty ghetto sewer. But what do you know, I can't do flow, just tell you hold it, let me go, cause I swing high.
Just keeping it up.
It's the capital I, man, I can't freak it with the freakable way that you can never understand. You know I rip it up from the outside, the inside. So tell me, who really is the man?
We're about to embark on a 33-day skating tour across America.
We're getting in this Winnebago, this 34-foot car, sort of, and we're going to drive across country and, you know, play our video games. Little kids are going to take us out, and we're going to hurt ourselves.
This is, yeah, this is every skater's dream. I can't believe it. It's really happening to me. You always think it's going to happen to somebody else, but, you know, it happened to me. It could happen to you too.
In each city you go to, there's all these little kids that want to skate with you, and there's so much stuff that you've always wanted to do that you finally get a chance to do it now.
From my 380, the funky Mexican Samoan, coming of course, I wanted to be the one to let you know when the time and location. Just keep the motivation.
This opportunity came up. I was just like, man, I gotta go, you know? I gotta be the one to be there. I mean, I dreamed this before it ever even was dreamt of, before anybody ever thought of it. I dreamt of this, and I knew this was gonna happen for me someday, and it has.
Slap you like a pimp when I sip with the funky mad tracker. Reckon shop in the sound lab that'll send you to the rehab. Before you step to this punk, don't forget the knee pad.
And be glad where you're coming from and where you're going to. Cause nobody cares for you, I thought you knew, but you don't have a clue. Microphone or pass it or end up in the casket. Hey, watch you see me blast it, I'm large like your basket.
There's a lot of kids out there. A lot of people doing really, really, really incredible things. And so now, instead of just taking together all this footage everyone says, that's where we're actually going out, we're getting it.
It's just a tragic because I got that wicked ass habit. You can't get enough of this funky stuff.
Every time we see a trick, we underestimate the talent that's out there. We say, oh, in a couple of years they'll be doing this, and then what do you know, in a month's time there's some kid who's 5'1", who lives in some small town, who can do it.
Sell it.
Yeah,
$2, you get like 30.
Woo! This is it.
So is there anything this else you guys want?
This rips on no one. This rips on no one.
Hey, B Harden. Come on, we're talking about food.
B, did you want
Hey, where is
Oh my god! This babe. Look at the food. Look at the food.
Was it a dream?
No, it's real.
Real. It's really real.
Scotty, Mike, you're all here. B, Brian, oh my God.
Bell, Tap Dance Lesson 101.
Man, you gotta do something, man. Freaking lanky ass. Pete.
Hey, man. Next time you slap me while I'm sleeping and I can't defend myself.
What's going on here?
My accuracy's kind of buckled.
I'm making some eggs. Stir up some vittles, get some damn protein, and just bam, hit the frail.
The original Shorty Rock Matty Matt's ripping in San Diego, California, charging at the rail. Go!
Yep. I've got a question for all you sinners. Have you ever wondered the interest of the Richmond life? Quick adventure, not much to mention. A slow procession leading us to die. Is there a heaven, a distant valley, a golden meadow waiting for us in the sky? No one right answers, spirits is broken. Still, I just can't help but wonder why.
I jump on big handrails, I jump over stuff, I just do whatever people don't think can be done, or things that you can get hurt doing. The type of girl, blonde hair or brown hair, I don't like her hair. Not too tall, like kind of short, and a rad body, really rad body.
And now I wonder, the sky I'm under, is there a hell I'm waiting for me when I die? And all my answers be left in front of me, so I just don't help but wonder why. Seems like a tactic waste of time. Who cares what happens when you die? Life is short to unwind. Get on with your life.
Up next, my dear friend Corey Nelson.
So many questions, I can't tell the difference. Too many abstract thoughts now wrestle in my mind. Two darkness, somewhere should be waiting. A final truth to shower me with light. The birth of wisdom, a death of glory. It's every night sleep till I found out it was all a lie. The one right answer, the red she's broken. Still I just can't help but wonder why. Seems like a tragic waste of time. Who cares what happens when you die?
Us in a little small compartment for about a month straight. Personally, myself, I think we're going to be okay. I think we're going to love each other. Everything's going to be great. A lot of people see this as the real world, where at first everything's hunky. Then in the future, all of a sudden people start dogging each other. And the next thing you know, it's another real world.
Okay, now. You ever choke me? You ever choke me? Hey, you're trying to get a fucking cup. Okay, the deal is this. A punch to my head is gonna get you a fucking knife in your throat.
Right, we call it. Left is nothing. Point that finger.
We don't care what you think. We don't care
what you think. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. Round
and center. Label breaker. Walk it clear. Get the mirror.
Yeah, John.
We don't care.
We don't care
what you think.
What you think.
We don't care.
We don't care
what you think.
Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, 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 oh.
Oh,
oh, oh,
oh.
You know, we're out here, we're in the New Boat store, rock and roll, and they bought us some beverages. And I'm on my bike. Later I'm going to be doing wheels and stuff on it.
That's the Rose. So I was doing my concert.
Is it him?
Slash, and I fall and I can't get out.
Come on,
Ned. Come on. Oh, I'm in here. Yes, talk to me.
Look out, honey. It's so hot tonight.
Yeah, our boy.
He's damn good.
Jesus, that's it.
Because I'm like, I'm fire, baby. I get it. Just cavity is looking at you because you look so weird. Wait.
Yeah.
it's a growing movement towards the faster and like smaller, more technical tricks. A lot of the kids these days, they got great balance, but they can't skate backwards. And the movement now is away from these huge rails and these curvy, kinky stuff, and now towards a more faster, more technical, more spinning variations. And it's a hell of a lot of fun.
You guys, I got a little lesson here for you guys. I see you're young guys coming up. If you ever have a rough night drinking, you're out all night, you know, you're having a lot of alcohol, the next morning, don't eat an apple or anything with like acid in it. You know, a lot of fruits have a lot of citric acid. Because Mike made that mistake just a couple of days ago, and he vomited all over the place.
Here's the apple I ate this morning.
And the burger I almost ate.
How did he do that?
Oh, there you go. Nice!
The blue pants on. They're bluish green.
The sweat.
Yeah, what's his name?
Ryan Smith.
Brian Smith.
So Brian, these girls, this one girl right here thinks you're cute and she would like to kiss you. Really?
Kiss my cheek.
Oh.
Thank you very much.
Well, hey, Arlo's stealing their car.
Brian, get in! Let's go!
Thank you.
for Johnny. Yeah, we're getting killed today.
We started here, then we went all the way to there, and then last night we drove there to down to Boulder, which is a little north of Denver. Then we were in Fort Collins. That's where we did our laundry and got drunk.
Now, far wide we searched the land. We found out Jimmy's sitting in the sand. Shades are on, he's in the house. He ran away with Mickey Mouse. He's in the shade, he's by the sea. He's under the branches of the happy tree. Said he's in the shade, by the sea.
Thought it'd be a secluded sport, if you want to call it a sport. But fuck that, man. It's getting big, man. Kids are going nutty. Like jumping on the handrail, they're jumping on the grind, jumping on all that shit, man. They're sliding down it, man. They're doing it. It's really tripped out.
It's such a new sport, and we've pushed it so far already that it's unbelievable some of the tricks people are pulling off, even though the sport's only, you know, so many years old. It's just becoming an insane sport.
The sport's gonna get very, very technical. It's gotten to the point that we're making our sport look hard, you know? It's not like you're gonna put on a pair of skates and you're just gonna go and put them on and start doing rails, you know? We don't want it like that.
The space between the pros and the beginners will just get absolutely enormous. Everything, it'll get bigger. It'll be like a spin to a disaster type trick, you know?
Apparently, it looks like Michael Palik needed a haircut, and Arlo was in the haircut mood. And a religious kind of thing took place here. Were those things that you guys put in your heads?
Yamaha, Yamakus.
He's got
a
Yamaha
in his head. Nebraska, wow, boom!
You just gotta have confidence. It's all confidence. You can't worry about what other people are saying about you or what other people say about your sport. You just have to do it because you love it and just worry about it by yourself, you know?
Really don't care how you feel. The place ain't no
natural just for you.
Shifty Royale. It's a hard trick.
He has great lines.
When I'm inline skating and I'm on the road and I'm tired, I reach for, that's right, folks, Gerber's baby food. It's got all the nutritious vitamins that I need to help me skate.
Da da da. Da da da.
Mm. Also, a good source of protein is Mighty Dog.
Mighty Dog in you.
Mighty Dog.
Josh said he's gonna be here like 2 hours.
somebody left him standing, and we had to make a sudden stop, and he just hit the floor, shatter. I mean, candy went all over the floor, man. People were diving, trying to get candy. People were coming from the aisles. I mean, it was just crazy, man. I didn't care about the candy. I cared about our Tom Servo, man. I really cared about him.
Okay, dude, this is a great, man. This is a good moment right now. We found this piece, two pieces, man. We can glue them back together like this, yo. Put it back on. Tom Servo's back, man. He's back in the game, man.
Nice.
Skating up for his first run is Blake.
Minneapolis.
He's a newcomer at the sport. He's going big on the top. Whoa, he's shorty rocked.
Make it perfect.
Yeah!
Welcome
back.
Make sure you clean them before you eat them.
My name is Stephen Thomas. I am 19 years old, and I'm from Minneapolis, Minnesota.
The Midwest is basically cool, great street riders. And we're all just a big happy family. Everybody's good friends. We always go out skating in large groups and we have a great time together doing the real hard stuff on the street. The street's where it's at. It's all on the street.
Shane Nelson. I'm from Minneapolis, Minnesota. I'm 17 years old. And is that it?
That's it.
Its own style, and it's just rad. Everyone's so innovative here, you know. This sport isn't like skateboarding now. It doesn't have its own rep. It's still here and there and everywhere, you know. I mean, aggressive skating will soon become, they won't even look at inliners the same as aggressive skaters. It'll be two different sports.
I can't see the future, but I know there will be one because people will always think of this stuff.
Jitters.
you check that it's acceptable to damage the lawn? Have you checked on
it? We're not damaging it. Look, it's dead.
Rock on! Rock on, Satan!
If Arlo was a sandwich, he would be the ham and cheese.
Definition of white trash. Wake up. Where's my Mountain Dew? He doesn't care what you say, this is public property. Wait. There's too many of us. It's not gonna work. But we would like something to eat, so if you can feed us, we might not escape.
What I'm more interested in is seeing, you know, not what's the gnarliest rail you can go to, but go to a decent rail, an average rail, and how many tricks can you do on that rail? I'm not talking about just variations, but how can you get on it? How can you get off it? What can you do while you're on it? And then that's where you get into style.
Work style is the most important part of it. If you can do a really hard trick, but if you make it look stinky and ugly, it doesn't count. It's gotta look good, or else it's worthless.
Some people may be able to do a lot of stuff, but no style. Now, even though they do the same things that other people do, they aren't looked up to as much as a person that can do it with style. Style is what life in general is about, style. No matter who you are or what you think, you've got style, you know? Arlo's got his own little style, he changes his haircuts, grows big pork chop sideburns, B's flashing that 70s look, you know? Michael Palak looks like a skinhead, Brooke looks like a... Brooke from New Zealand. It makes skating exciting because each person has their own little style, you know?
Style is just the way you present yourself and the way that you act and the way you pull your tricks. And everybody has their own style because everybody's different.
I mean, style is all relative, you know? You could go out there and see someone that just rips but has no style, but you know, you may feel they have a whole bunch of style, you know, and it's all what you think looks cool. And I think it eventually comes down to fun, as long as you're out there having fun. And I mean, you can go down a rail if it's fun for you and you look like you're out of control. I mean, hey, don't let anyone tell you. Take it out to the customer, it could be a good dinner, but man, it don't look very good, you know? So that right there is gonna depreciate from the meaning of the meal. Now you can fix the dinner, put it all on the plate nice and pretty, you put different colors in, you stir the mustard or whatever you wanna do to it, you make it look beautiful. Hell man, you can probably have a meal and still think it looks good, you know?
Should not be the highlight of our sport. What? People get off on that. It looks funny when a guy nuts himself on a rail. We do it a lot in our sport. So it's really easy to just want to make a little segment and have a bunch of kids fall on the balls.
Thank you. You okay, Steve?
Ow, that hurts.
I just hit my Judy. Oh, I'm glad I don't have.
Keeping me real.
Word up.
Gotta be careful when you're on rails, especially this one.
Yeah.
You've been practicing doctoring long?
About 10 years.
Yeah? You see a lot of rollerbladers?
Yeah, that's the new scourge of society as far as trauma goes, is rollerblading.
Whoa! Oh! Right
out, dude. Did a backflip, very stalled out. Landed all on my shoulders.
Look at how red his back is.
A little bit skinny helmet on the shoulder there. Oh
my God. What would have happened if you didn't have your helmet?
Killed myself.
Up next, Dallas, Texas.
Yeehaw.
Thank you.
know that Arlo has a Prince Albert, right?
Is this like, are you like gonna give me, is this a dirty joke?
No, I'm
What's
not
What's a
kidding.
Prince Albert?
You don't know what a Prince Albert is?
I swear when I was in high school there was like dang up Prince Albert and
what do you think
can.
About, what do you think about body piercing?
Arlo doesn't have anything pierced. Does he? Arlo? Did you get your penis pierced?
What?
Are you kidding?
You know, and you know I know.
I know what?
You know I know. It's Prince Albert in a can.
Prince Albert in a can. Okay. I love you, Mom. Bye.
Thank you all. Thank you for that page.
Hey, don't tell Dad about, you know, our little secret.
He'll never find out.
Yo, what's up, y'all? This is Brother Bones down with the Hoax 2 film crew. And these boys are insane. We're talking kamikaze on skates. The fattest, the flyest, in-flight line skating you'll ever see in your entire life. Right here, captured by T-Bone Films, baby. Mm.
Okay, Mikey, just stay still.
The future is some kid sitting out practicing every day with some trick that everybody's gonna go, there's no way in hell you're gonna do that, man. The kid's determined to, he keeps doing it over and over, and when he gets it down, he shows it to somebody, and they all just go, damn, that's gonna revolutionize the sport.
Up next, Corey Donahue.
We'll be right back.
Jonathan Vainwright. I'm 13, and I'm from Alexandria, Virginia. I think that aggressive skating is going to get a lot bigger in the future, and I think it's going to, there is no limits. We can take it as far as we want, as long as we don't run out of rails.
Legs on the streets, controlling police, leading the flames, raging from body cars, legend starts, oh, we are alive.
Nice.
Just feeding off each other's energy. I do a couple tricks, stoke him out, he does a couple of tricks, and just goes back and forth.
I'll tell you, he's the man, he's the man.
Partners in line, together forever.
Take care.
See ya. Hoax 2, buy it, live it, love it, but don't bootleg it.
See, when we go to each college campus, we like to take care of, you know, the people that, you know, founded the place, Ben Franklin, for instance. You know, he's got balls of brass.
Going out for theirs.
good reason to wear your safety gear.
Got to go when you got the chance. But, you know, it's always hanging over your head. You know, there might be somebody right in your way. It's a constant battle.
My boy here, man, sick, man. You know, he's comfortable on the kinked rail, but I don't know, something happened. He jumped on it. It seemed like he had rocket back. When he looked forward, rocket kick in, afterburner. He flew off the end of the rail. His foot slipped, and he dove backwards probably about a total of about 8 feet in the air.
Oh, my God.
Ryan. Ryan. You okay? Break anything?
You never can get too comfortable on a kinked rail. When if you're doing a kinked rail without thinking about it, you need to stop and analyze what you're doing. You're grinding a kinked rail, man. That's scary.
I love the fact that you face that every time you take a rail. You face that death factor, and it scared me to death. I mean, I never hit that hard in my life, and it hurt. And I thought I wasn't getting up. Luckily, I got out of it. Nothing serious. You know, maybe I broke my finger, that's gonna be a while to heal, and the back is not broken, so, you know, you just cut your losses, you move on. And I'm so stupid that I'll just forget about it. Once I'm healed, pain is gone, I won't remember it. And I'll wait for it to happen again, then I'll recall on it.
Yo, welcome to New York, where if you don't entertain us, you take your skates and you walk the home.
It's like 15,000,000 people just walking around, bothering you, telling you you can't skate here. And we tell them to go to hell because we don't care. We don't do anything bad. All we want to do is skate. And that's what we're going to continue to do until my legs fall out. So we're going to pretty much do it forever because New York is the street capital of the world.
It's all about respect. It's all about being the best. It's very competitive. It's bad, but it's the New York way.
You don't have someone to do it with. It's not worth doing to all my
just have to get known. I've been skating for 2 years already. No one even knows my name. I just want people to know me.
We have this thing called family skating. You skate with your boys, and that's all you skate with. That's who makes you feel good when you're skating with them.
Looks like a caveman, but he got good style.
I guess New York skaters really don't give a whatever.
Money-making Manhattan, and I'm 16 years old.
Evan, that was a fine show this evening. On behalf of Skippy the Bounder, Brooke Howard Smith, Michael O'Palley, myself, and the rest of T-Bone Films and the Hoax Anarchy Across America tour, I'd like to present you with this Senate Angry Youth cap. I hope you'll wear it with pride, and never mind the taco sting. Here you go.
house of infinite styles.
The meaning of life. The world is dictated by one thing. It's all about dick size. So if you got it, you got it. If you don't got it, hey.
Hey, what up, man? Representing the East Coast. Talking about somebody who's totally earning their respect from the West Coast on the East Coast, earning their respect big time. All owing the boys amongst all you skating.
We got suits, we got blazers, we got poplins, tuxedos, sport coats, everything going at must sell prices.
Yeah, hopefully you better call up Brooklyn and tell them just like going down the line.
New York always represents. These guys come out, man, they knew we were coming to town. It's like they're all packed, they're all excited, ready to go, all eager to skate.
Laters in New York, we're not known and so like, we're all like competing against each other just to get known and shit. Like, one person will try the hardest throw just to get known. Once they get known, then they're happy, man. I've been skating for 2 years, you know, busting my ass, skating hard, and I still don't feel that I have the respect that I deserve. It's your respect. You just want it. You want people to know that you're doing something, and you want them to know that you're good.
My name is Christian Batista, and I'm from New York, and I'm 12 years old.
Every time you go out there, you gotta skate hard to keep up with everybody and to be original, you know, because you can't fall behind. So every day is like a skating for a video day.
And Calvin here, he's never gotten a free thing in his life, you know. He's just a kid who likes to skate. And he just came into the band, he saw Rollinson's brand new Rossi skates, unused, never been used, man. So he wants to battle Rollinson for the skates.
Come on, you bastard. We're in New York City, we're about to have a battle. What we got here is Rollinson versus Calvin. They're gonna get 5 hits. B, Brooke and I are all gonna be judging each hit on a scale of 1 to 10 with the Skip-O cards. And we're gonna keep the scores right here. We got Rollinson, Calvin, a brick for each hit, and a place for each person's score. And then at the end, each score, every hit counts, will be tallied for a grand total, and then whoever's got the most points at the end is the winner and wins the other person's pair of skates. Oh. Front side to X, right?
Oh. Yep.
Shit, man.
I like that.
That's called a comeback, kids.
Oh! Oh, my God. Now that was a far side of the shit, so.
Oh! It's real close, but those skates are looking pretty good on
Calvin.
Damn!
Regular 5.
Oh! He fell!
Oh my God, that was as good as it gets.
For the attempt, we're gonna give him.
Yeah.
Thank you.
For the sport, I'm happy. I mean, I'm ecstatic. The way we've been received all across the country, especially the things like, I mean, New York, you know, the scene's huge. That was awesome. while we were still in California, you know, things we expected it to be great there. And Minnesota and Nebraska, all these places where you know the scene is healthy, cool. But then when we showed up at a place like Little Rock, and the kind of reception we got there, I mean, that was incredible. And that was really gratifying, you know, to see just how healthy our sport is.
Cannot skate up here at all.
The Secretary of Labor did not want them on the nobody.
He said, hey, Mr. Lindsay, can you guys come by?
You guys are not allowed up here.
So in lines is pretty much is like it's in now, so I like to get the new ones to have the brakes in the back.
Okay. We got nothing better to do, so we gotta come after this shit.
We're not responsible for you if you get injured or hurt.
No, these guys though, they're all pro skaters.
You know, and can't skate on the field.
Right, I told them.
Okay.
There you go.
We're wrong. See those little kids?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
They don't want you here.
Okay, we're sorry.
It's totally illegal.
We're sorry.
You're trespassing on school grounds.
Okay.
You're filming in the city of Pacific Grove without a filming permit. Okay. So I'm going to need to see some identification from all three of you in order to issue some citations.
Get your ass out of here. I'll have you arrested. Get out!
At all. It's just like a sidewalk.
You have to go.
It's a public sidewalk.
You have to go.
It's a public sidewalk.
It's private granite. You have to go.
Hey! Down!
Wait!
Look at this!
Whoa! Look at that!
It's private property!
Okay.
Are you guys going to pay for this?
Let me tell you what I'll do. You come to me to my office. We'll call our insurance company. They say it's fine. Then it's fine.
NRB does not go well at this college.
Well, there was a traveling group of inline skaters.
Yeah, hi there. Shut the damn thing off.
Okay.
You know how many times I've been hurt on public property? Never sued, not one time.
Because you don't do it, but the chances are you could do it.
Because he's doing his job as a security guard and stopping you, because if he don't, he can lose his job.
Yes, that is true. That's the main reason why he's doing it.
As far as I'm concerned, I don't see nothing. You understand what I'm saying? But it's a thing like I was telling my man. It's such a thing called courtesy. Yo, who lives here? Who's the tenant association? Yo, is it all right if you do this here, we do this here? I don't mind it.
All right, just start to push me.
No, I can't do that. It's against policy.
Okay. Did you ever fisk a guy and like say, No. You sure? Are you married? No.
11 and a half. Here we go. Oh.
I jacked my arm.
What just happened?
I jacked my fucking rib.
He's going for the new school, busting limits. Alley-oop soul to 270 switch stance. It's not an easy move. And we're doing it at night.
Full props to B. Harden.
Hey, Brian,
can't
you go
breathe
get
very well.
Evan,
this is a I'm not breathing shot. Too well.
Just hold up, man.